I was always fascinated by the brain as a student, and it was actually my first research experience as an undergraduate student. It was in a Parkinson's lab.
One of the reasons why I headed down this path was that lack of disease-modifying therapies that, you know, was very evident to me when I was deciding what kind of neurologist to be.
This is a brain disease where we can only offer symptomatic therapy, and it's long overdue that we put a dent into it. My dream is that in the future, as you and I can get a cholesterol test to determine whether we're at higher risk or lower risk of having a cardiac event or having a stroke, we want to be able to apply a high or low risk score to determine whether you're at risk of Parkinson's down the road. I told my wife on a number of occasions that I'm not going to retire until we put the first dent into this illness, even if it takes me another 15 or 20 years.
I really felt that more work needed to be done in how we care for patients from a very holistic perspective. You can't rehab the body without taking into account things like anxiety and grief and depression and low motivation and apathy, which are so common in Parkinson's. There's lots of specialists and experts across the country who are doing some cool work, and so Parkinson Canada has been really instrumental in the last 5 years in bringing those people together at the table.
Parkinson Canada was really instrumental for me, as probably for many researchers across Canada, in when I was starting. So I received the new Investigator Award, and as the name implies, it's awarded to new investigators. That award was used to fuel a very important project that's actually still ongoing in my lab. It's focused on a genetic form of Parkinson's disease caused by a gene called LRRK2, or LRRK2. So if you saw a patient who had typical Parkinson's disease or LRRK2 Parkinson's disease, they look very, very similar. But when these patients go to autopsy, the pathology can be very different.
Parkinson Canada took a chance on us to actually study this thing that is a little bit controversial, and we've actually found some really cool findings. So centered around the idea that alpha-synuclein, when it goes into the nucleus of these cells, it can actually be toxic. Thanks to this funding, we're able to make those initial discoveries, and we've actually built on that to apply for additional funding from the Government of Canada.
They're like one of the many connections that we have, but the one that I think the most aligns with our mandate. And that allyship is really, really important, and I think a lot of interesting projects are going to come out of that coming down the road.